What's up guys, welcome back to another exciting tech tutorial. Ever wanted to run Linux on your Windows machine? Well, today we are diving into the world of virtual machine and we will be using VirtualBox to set up Ubuntu right inside your Windows 11 PC. Okay, but first you have to enable virtualization in your PC. If you have not enabled virtualization on your PC yet, check out my video in the description below. Okay, so let's get started. So first we need to download and install Oracle VirtualBox. So first open your web browser and search for download VirtualBox and go to the VirtualBox websites. Here you can see the latest VirtualBox version 7.0.18 platform package. From here download the latest version of Windows host. Okay, just click on this. It's nearly 104 MB size, so download can take few seconds depending on your internet speed. Okay. Once the download is complete, run the installer and you can follow the on-screen instruction to install VirtualBox on your computer. Once you have VirtualBox installed, now we need to download Ubuntu ISO. Okay, so for that, open your browser again and here you need to search for Ubuntu download. And in the search result, go to the Ubuntu websites. And here you will find download 24.04 LTS button. And here it is clearly mentioned that this is the latest LTS version of Ubuntu for desktop PC and laptop. LTS stands for long term support, which means 5 years of free security and maintenance update. Okay, so just click on this button and download gets started. It's around 6 GB of size, so this might take a few minutes depending on your internet speed. Okay, once the Ubuntu ISO ready and we already have VirtualBox, so it's time to create our virtual machine. Okay, so search Oracle VirtualBox and open it on your Windows machine. Once it is open, click the new button to create a new virtual machine. And in the next window, give your virtual machine a name. For example, I'm going to name it Ubuntu 2024. And leave the folder as it is. And now select the ISO image and select others and find the location where you have downloaded the Ubuntu ISO. Now check the box says skip unattended installation and click on next. Here VirtualBox needs a certain amount of RAM for your virtual machine. You can adjust this based on your system available memory. And a minimum of 2 GB is recommended. Okay, but 4 GB or more will provide better performance. And set processor CPU as per your availability. Then click next to proceed. Here you will create a virtual hard disk for your Ubuntu virtual machine. Select create a virtual hard disk now. I'm going to set it 50 GB, which is enough for Ubuntu. As you know, Ubuntu takes very small space. Okay. Then click on next to move to the final summary screen. Review the settings for your virtual machine and make sure everything looks good, especially the RAM location and the storage size. After that, click on finish to create the virtual machine. Now in the left pane, you will see your Ubuntu 2024 is ready. Now you need to select your newly created virtual machine and click on start button. And in the virtual machine, we'll boot from the Ubuntu ISO file and launch the Ubuntu installer. Now here you can see Ubuntu installation process will begin. Select try your install Ubuntu on the welcome screen and press enter on keyboard. Okay. One information page will pop up. You need to just click on capture to use the host mouse for virtual machine. Now proceed with the installation and wait for the further options. And here click on the Install Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. This might look different for other Ubuntu versions. You may hear Ubuntu welcome sound. And choose your desired language and click on Next. And here you can customize your needs before installation and click on Next. Select keyboard layout. Just click on the Next button and proceed. Choose your preferred internet connection and you can click Next. If any update for this installation will pop up, you can skip this for your future. Okay. Now, would you like to install Ubuntu? I like to select interactive installation for step-by-step guide and click Next. What apps would you like to install to start with? Select default selection and click Next. Click both boxes on this page. This will ensure that everything Ubuntu needs to run will be installed. And click on Next. Check the erase disk and install Ubuntu box. This may sound scary, but don't worry, nothing in your computer will be erased. And then click on Next. Now here you need to create your account. Give your account a name and I'm going to name it Tech Infokart. And we need to put some password and then again confirm password. Click on Next to further proceed. Here set your location and click on Next to continue. Here you can review your choices and finally click on Install. Now simply wait for the installation process to complete. This process may take up to half an hour depending on your speed of your computer. So won't need to do anything during the installation process. Just wait for the finish, okay? Once the installation process is over, here you will see Ubuntu 24.04 LTS is installed and ready to use. Now you need to click the Restart Now to complete the installation. You need to press on Enter key on keyboard. Once your Ubuntu virtual machine is back on, select your name, then enter your password, and press enter. And voila, you are finished with the installation process and you will notice the welcome screen. There is some additional setting, so click on Next. Now it will ask for Ubuntu Pro. Select Skip for now and click Next. Again click Next and finally click on Finish. Your Ubuntu installation is now complete and your virtual machine is ready to go. Now you can explore the world of Linux right from your Windows 11 computer. Okay. Now you can do coding, testing application or just exploring. Ubuntu on VirtualBox provides a fantastic and versatile environment, isn't it? So to make this full screen, just click on View. Then select full screen mode and from this pop-up click on switch and you will have a full screen Ubuntu in your PC. Okay, you can see. And if you want to get back to your regular desktop view, simply press the right side control key plus F key on your keyboard. This will toggle you out from the full screen mode. Okay, that's it for today's video. We have successfully created a virtual machine on Windows 11 using VirtualBox and installed Linux Ubuntu. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe for more tech tutorials like this. If you have any question or run into any issue, drop a comments below and I will be happy to help. Okay, so thanks for watching and see you in the next video.